हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ऑन द टॉपिक कैटल मैस्टाइटिस। दिस प्रेजेंटेशन इज प्रिपेयर्ड बाय यतीन जिंदल, आकाशदीप, निर्मल कुमावत, अनिकेत कुमार एंड नरसिंह। यतीन विल स्टार्ट विद द इंट्रोडक्शन एंड देन आकाशदीप विल एक्सप्लेन द कंपोजिशनल चेंजेस एंड डिटेक्शन ऑफ मैस्टाइटिस बाय सोमैटिक सेल काउंट मेथड। And after that, Nirmal Kumawat and Aniket Kumar will explain the detection of mastitis by chemical and microbiological method. And at last, Narsingh will explain the CAM test and significance of mastitis milk. So let's start with the topic. What is mastitis? Mastitis is the inflammation of one or more quarters of the udder caused by microbial infections. As we can see the diagram drawn below of the udder of normal cow and the udder of cow suffering from mastitis. Mastitis affects around 25 to 30% of all quarters. It is a most costly disease of dairy cattle. Now let's discuss about the health concerns of mastitis. Mastitis affects on animal health as well as on human health. Effect on animal health. First, loss of functional quarter. Secondly, milk production becomes low, and at last it may even lead to death of the animals. Effect on human health. Quality of milk becomes very poor. Secondly, antibiotic residues arises in milk as the tolerance limit of antibiotic is just 10 microgram per liter of milk. Now let's discuss about the major microorganisms responsible for causing mastitis. First one is bacteria. Bacteria are the major mastitis causing microorganism. Staphylococcus aureus and Streptococcus aegypti are the two major bacteria causing mastitis. Yeasts and molds are also responsible for causing mastitis. Mastitis can also be caused physically by trauma, that is a deeply distressing experience, or weather extremes. Categories of mastitis. Mastitis is categorized either on the basis of symptoms or on the basis of causative agent. On the basis of symptoms, mastitis is classified as acute, subacute and chronic. And on the basis of causative agents, it is classified as common mastitis, contagious mastitis and summer mastitis. Mastitis based on symptoms. First one is acute. Acute mastitis occurs for short period of time. Under this, milk becomes very thick and symptoms can be seen. Second one is subacute. Subacute mastitis under this infection occurs without apparent sign of inflammation and no change is seen in the udder. And at last one is chronic mastitis. Chronic mastitis occurs for long period of time. Based on causative agent, first one is common mastitis. Common mastitis is caused by Staphylococcus aureus. Second one is contagious mastitis. Contagious mastitis are those mastitis which can be spread from one animal to another. This mastitis is caused by Streptococcus aegypti. Third one is summer mastitis. Summer mastitis is caused by Corynebacterium bacterium pyogenesis.
Let's come to the compositional changes in milk due to mastitis. Due to this disease, milk production decreases drastically, mainly due to damaging of udder tissue or a scar tissue formation in udder. And milk that is produced from this infected udder has increased somatic cell count. In somatic cell, especially epithelial cell and leukocyte cells. Due to these changes in somatic cell count, as we see in the table, level of total solid lactose, total casein, fat content decreases, and level of total whey protein and certain ions like sodium ion, chloride ion, copper ion, ferrous ion, zinc ion increases significantly. Change in somatic cell count has also affected the yield of cheese, especially cheddar cheese. As we see in the table, as count of somatic cell increases per ml, the yield of cheddar cheese decreases significantly. Now due to this udder disease, the pH of milk also get increases and goes above 7. Various enzymes and glycoprotein concentration that are present in milk also get increases significantly. Electric potential of milk also get disrupted. Now come to the detection of milk. It involves two methods. First, chemical method and second, microbiological method. First, chemical method. It includes various types of test, namely sodium lauryl sulfate test, California mastitis test, pH test, chloride test, catalase test, rhizagurine Raynaud test. Now let come to the first, SLST test, namely sodium lauryl sulfate test. This test is used to detect mastitis milk by presumptive determining somatic cell count in milk. This test is based on effect on viscosity of milk after adding sodium lauryl sulfate solution to milk. Here, 2 ml of milk is added to 2 ml of test solution and gently shake it for 20 seconds in tube and observed for coagulation of leukocyte. Here we see, if no viscous layer present, there is no mastitis condition and the leukocyte cell are less than 1 lakh. If there is slight viscous layer, then there is a condition of subacute mastitis and leukocyte cell ranges between 1 lakh to 5 lakh. If central viscous cone present in the solution and disappear after a stopping rotation, then there is a condition of acute mastitis and leukocyte cell ranges from 5 lakh to 50 lakh cell per ml. If central cone persists after a stopping rotation, then cell are more than 50 lakh and there is also acute condition of mastitis. Now let's come to the California mastitis test. This test is rapid test done by farmer even at farm level to identify subclinical or chronic mastitis. Here milk is taken from each quarter of udder on 4 cup plastic paddle as it is shown here and then mix equal part of CMT reagent to the milk. Now after mixing it for a minute, we see the solution. If mixture remain liquid with no evidence of precipitate, then negative and there is no case of mastitis. If slight precipitate or flakes form and then disappear, then there is a condition of trace mastitis. If distinct precipitate and mixture thickens immediately and some gel formation, then mastitis persists even for more than 2 weeks. Now come to the scores of CMT. If it is negative, then the number of cells vary from 0 to 2 lakh cells. Namely, here cells are leukocyte cell. If there is a condition of trace mastitis, then cell vary from 2 lakh to 4 lakh cell. If there is mastitis persists more than 2 weeks, then cell ranges from 12 lakh to 50 lakh cells.
Hello everyone, this is Nirmal Kumar. Today we will talk about detection of mastitis milk by chemical method. We already know what is mastitis. It is inflammation of one or more quarters of the udder. My friend already discussed some chemical method. Now I continue this portion. Let's we discuss pH test. The pH of normal milk varies between 6.6 to 6.8. The milk from infected udder is usually alkaline in reaction with pH is 7 to 7.4. And this can be detected by observing the color change shown by a suitable pH indicator, bromomethyl blue added to milk. Mastitis milk has greater than 6.8 pH. For procedure, take 5 ml milk is mixed with 1 ml of 0.04% bromomethyl blue and color change is observed. Blue green to green color is indicate of mastitis, whereas normal milk show yellow color. Now let's we discuss chloride test. The chloride content increase in milk of animals suffering from mastitis. Normal milk has a chloride content of 0.08 to 0.14% and abnormal milk has more than 0.14% chloride. If the sample contains an abnormally high percentage of chloride, the red color will change to yellow to indicate a positive test. A brownish red color indicates a negative test. We get result that normal milk, the amount of oxygen liberated will be about 2 ml and more than 2.5 ml of gas collected in the top of the tube is presumed to be due to an abnormal infected udder. Now let's we discuss catalase test. We already know that living cells including leukocytes contain the enzyme catalase. The number of leukocytes in the milk increasing during infection of udder. Catalase test is used to measure the increase in catalase depending on the ability of it to break down hydrogen peroxide. Milk of animal in early or late lactation may give false positive test to catalase. For procedure, to take 15 ml of milk in a test tube, add 5 ml of 1% H2O2 solution and inverted tube and incubate at 37 degrees Celsius for 3 hours. Oxygen collect at upper portion. Now we discuss Rajorin-Rennie test. Rajorin-Rennie test for diagnosis of bovine mastitis was devised. A tablet of Rajorin and Rennet was placed in a sterile test tube to which 10 ml of milk were added directly from a teeth. This method is simply and practically used for diagnosis of bovine mastitis. Rennet coagulation time will increase for mastitis milk.
Now, detection of mastitis milk by microbiological method. In microbiological method, we can use following test for detection of mastitis milk. First will be microscopic observation, Hotis test, blood agar test and CAMP test. I will discuss microscopic observation. Presence of long chains of streptococcus is indicative of mastitis due to streptococcus agalaxia. Occurrence of staphylococcus aureus is also indicative of mastitis. Now Hotis test. Hotis test differentiate between staphylococcus aureus and streptococcus agalaxia. First image will be Staphylococcus aureus and second will be Streptococcus agalaxia. Procedure of Hotis test. Take 9.5 ml of milk in a test tube. Add 0.5 ml of 0.5% bromocresol purple in a test tube. After that, test tube is inverted several times for mixing. Then, test tube is incubated at 37 degrees centigrade for 24 to 48 hours. And observe the color of test tube. Presence of yellow color indicates infection with Streptococcus agalaxia. And presence of rusty brown color indicates presence of Staphylococcus aureus. Now I will discuss blood agar test. Blood agar test also differentiate between Streptococcus agalaxia and Staphylococcus aureus. Procedure of blood agar test. Pre-incubated mastitis milk sample are streaked on blood agar. After that, incubated at 37 degrees centigrade for 24 hours and observe the formation of colory and color of the test tube. Observation of alpha and beta hemolysis will occur in Streptococcus agalaxia and only alpha hemolysis occur in Streptococcus dysagalaxia. No reaction occur in Streptococcus ubris and only beta hemolysis occur in Staphylococcus aureus.
CAMP test. It is a microbiological test which is used to identify group B streptococci, that is Streptococcus agalaxiae. CAMP test stands for Christy, Atkins and Munich-Peterson test. Principle: group B streptococcus produces a protein which is known as CAMP factor. This protein acts synergistically with beta lysine of Staphylococcus aureus. It enhances the lysis of red blood cells. In this test, the group B streptococci are strict perpendicular to a streak of Staph aureus on a sip blood agar. In a positive reaction, an arrowhead is appeared at the place where the two lines come in proximity. Now coming to its procedure, we have to streak a beta lysine producing strain of Staph aureus down the center in a sip blood agar plate. This streak should be 3 to 4 cm long. Now streak test organism across the plate perpendicular to this Staph aureus streak. Incubate it at 35 to 37 degrees Celsius in ambient air for 24 hours. As we can see in this image, the vertical streak is of Staphylococcus aureus and this horizontal streak is of group B streptococci. In this reaction, there will be formation of arrowhead, as we can see. Significance of mastitis. First of all, we will discuss it on farmer level. Due to mastitis, both milk yield and lactation period decreases. The milk produced by the animal also looks watery, and there may be presence of clots in it. So farmer does not get the price of milk. Now coming to the quality of milk. Due to mastitis, there are many compositional changes in the milk. So overall, there is a disturbance in the salt balance. Heat stability of milk decreases due to disturbance of salt balance. So it coagulates upon heating. During mastitis, leukocytes are present in milk. Leukocytes are the immune cells. These cells kill starter culture bacteria, so starter culture fails. In case of cheese, both yield and quality decreases. There occurs fat loss in whey, and rennet coagulation time also increases. For a specific cheese, there is a specific casein to fat ratio. We cannot attain that in case of mastitis milk. It is also harmful from public health point of view, as mastitis milk may contain pathogens like Staphylococcus aureus. Thank you very much.